Right now, the ripple effect of what those students are doing down in Parkland and how they have students who are willing to walk out, I mean, this is a really powerful movement that we're seeing. At the same time, there are a lot of people in the Black community who say, what about Black Lives Matter? When Black Lives Matter organized and tried to speak up on behalf of Black people who were murdered, there wasn't as much support. There was a lot of pushback. Why do you think the movements, Parkland students and gun control, are being received a little bit differently than Black Lives Matter?
Well, first of all, God bless these children who are turning their tragedy into their mission, really, to prevent other kids to have this never happen again. And I think they are brilliant activists. They are showing incredible ability to break through all the normal noise that diffuses, dispels, disperses energy towards gun safety measures. Mm-hmm. So God bless them for doing that. But in their call, never again, we who live in communities like mine, I'm the only senator that lives in a Black community, low-income Black community, in an inner city. And I know what the reality is. They say never again, but every single day in America, every single day, we have in the aggregate a mass shooting. About 30 plus people who are being killed, and often they are low-income people, people of color, people who seem to be not getting the kind of attention or the care or the concern, or they don't motivate the moral urgency to deal with these problems. Those of us who live in cities know the street level shrines on street corners for where people died. Those of us who live in inner city communities know the sound of gunfire on a regular basis. There was a shooting in this last year right across the street from where I live, not to mention up the block, not to mention around the corner. And so I live with the prevalence of gun violence, even though Newark's been doing a great job under Mayor Baraka in driving down our overall violence rates. One shooting is too many in any neighborhood or any community. One child's death is too many in any community. And too many of our cities see this on multiple times. And so this should be a call for all of us, and it should be a call of urgency every single day. And this doesn't even include the women who are one of the largest numbers of people being murdered on a daily basis by their partners, by their stalkers, by their ex-boyfriends or ex-husbands. Where's the moral outrage about the level of domestic violence and domestic murder that's going on in this country? So I'm very happy and proud of these young people who've been able to prick the consciousness of this country, motivate action. You see the polling numbers shifting as a result of their testimony. But I will not let people forget that this is a crisis that goes on. Even in the time that we're having this this interview, there's someone out there, or many out there, that are living in fear for their lives because of the prevalence of gun violence in their community. And why? Why? These guns are not being manufactured in communities like mine. These guns are coming into our communities in the hands. In fact, when I was mayor of the city, all of our shootings, except for one, which was done by a correctional officer, all of our shootings and murders, everyone we looked at least, was done by a criminal who got their hands on their gun that shouldn't have been able to buy a gun. It is far too easy for people in this country who should not be able to get guns to be able to get guns. And that's why. And many of these guns in places like Newark, places like Chicago, come from out of state and benefit from lax, incomplete background checks. So there are common sense things that we can do. In fact, states that do comprehensive background checks see their violence against women, the murders associated with women, go down around 40%. And so I live with this. I have fears and concerns for myself, my neighbors, the family that lives with me. I live with this. I don't want to see another mass shooting, period. But I don't need a mass shooting to awaken my sense of urgency on these issues. And we should have a conversation that is inclusive, where there's intersectionality, because this issue deals with issues of race, it deals with issues of sexual violence against women, it deals with issues of mental health. There are so many issues that come together that manifest, erupt when a gun is in the hands of somebody that shouldn't have it, or a weapon of war is on our community streets.